This video covers the process of creating animations. We will create an idle animation, a run animation, and an attack animation that will attack with a sword. This video includes a rough process of creating 2D animations and some tips. Unlike demo samples, morph modifier and physics modifier are omitted from this video. Add transform by animation modifier. Create idle animation clip. After setting up the mesh group, add a timeline. Register all the bones as timeline layers. Set the time of the animation and turn on the loop option. In this sample, I created an animation with two poses, including a slight backstroke posture from idle posture. Use the onion skin function to compare with the previous posture. To create an easy posture, set the position with the pelvis and make the leg posture. Let's hide the mesh for a while, and compare the bones to make a posture. Now we modify the shape of the body and arms. Drag to copy the keyframes holding Ctrl key. An animation has now been created to switch between the two poses. To make it look more natural, add and modify keyframes. Now it looks a little better. Let's make an intermediate posture to move the legs. It's a pretty good animation. Here are a simple tip. If the keyframes of all parts are in the same frame, they look fairly artificial. So we distribute the keyframes of each bones. If the motion starts at the center of the body, it is natural to move the keyframe of the arm, head, or clothes backwards. Let's apply this tip a bit more and make cool animations. Let's make an animation where two scarves behind a character's neck are fluttering. It is not difficult to create an animation with clothes fluttering. First, the scarf repeatedly flaps upward and downward. It is still a little naturally. Now, let's apply the tip mentioned above. The more out of the bones in the scarf, the more the keyframe moves backwards. Now we have a pretty nice scarf animation. Let's create an animation for the skirt bones and complete it. Next, let's create a run animation. Add timeline and timeline layers. Set the time of the animation and create keyframes that will be the two default postures. Go to the first frame and make the right leg forward. Create a second posture. Now the left leg makes a forward position. At this time, her left arm goes backward and her right arm goes forward. An animation has been created with alternating left and right legs. Now each creates a posture between them. Previously, the foot on the back was touching the ground, this time creating an attitude in which the front foot touches the ground. The opposite postures are created in the same way. Basically, it looks like running forward. I made the body move back and forth to express a dynamic figure, but it was a bit unnatural, so I corrected it. If you have modified the keyframes of body and legs, then modify the posture of both arms. As the legs and arms moved, a modestly good animation was created. Now, let's improve it more naturally. Correct the posture of the front legs before stepping on the ground and when stepping on. You can turn on the onion skin to see if the height of feet are constant. You can change the options of onion skin by pressing the control key and clicking the Show Onion Skin button. You can work intuitively with only the foot bone visible. Let's check whether the orbit of the foot is abnormal. Let's make the other side posture the same way. I modified the position of the pelvis bone to create a running motion, which seems a bit awkward. So I modified this. Modify body and head bones. The running force makes the body shrink and stretch. Let's take a tip on spreading keyframes that we learned when we created our idle animation. Running starts with the legs, so move the keyframes of the arms and head bones back a little. Now complete the animation using the techniques you learned earlier. It also creates scarf animations. Create an animation using the method you learned while creating an idle animation. Let's create an attack animation that will swing the sword. This animation is not a loop and must be connected in idle posture. Therefore, copy and place the default posture in the first and last frames. Attack animations like swinging a sword look great when they are divided into preparation, action, and recovery phases. Create a posture of the action phase that is the first key. I tried to make the character swing the sword down strongly. Now is the preparation phase to take just before the attack. It is the posture that lifts the sword to vigorously swing. Since the preparation phase is not much different from idle, turn on the onion skin and work on it. The preparatory and action steps are now complete. Let's create a recovery phase by copying the keyframes of the action phase. By inertia, the body goes down further, and the legs are a little further away. Try to stop the sword, but move a little. Modify the recovery phase a bit more. To make the posture stand up again after the attack, let's modify the body position and the foot position. Create an intermediate posture for other bones. The basic animation flow is complete. Let's try to distribute keyframes. Since this animation has a momentary impact, there is not much distribution of keyframes. Creates animations of scarves. When I make the motion of the scarf, the rigging value is a bit strange. I selected a mesh group and modified rigging. Now complete the animation. Select root unit and check out the completed animations.